Here are all my issues of Doctor Who magazine, starting on the left from the early issues when it was Doctor Who Weekly to the late 1980s or so, and then to the 1990s, the 2000s, and on your right you have the more recent issues, and the box on the very left are some other related Doctor Who magazines, like fanzines like The Frame and DWB, TV Zone, and so forth. So we're just going to take a look at them, and I have to do it pretty quickly because I only got about 20 minutes on my memory card here. So let's take a look. So this is Doctor Who Weekly number one. Now this actually isn't an original. This is a replica facsimile edition that appeared in Doctor Who Magazine number 350, an anniversary issue. I used to have the very first issue, but I ended up selling it later when I did a side-by-side comparison of the facsimile and the original. I decided, I only needed one, so I decided to keep the facsimile edition. So technically, I don't have Doctor Who Weekly number one, but I used to have it. And in fact, one of my videos from like 5 years ago shows my Doctor Who magazines, and you'll be able to see my original Doctor Who one and Weekly number one on there. Issue number 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Issue number 9. Issue number 10. Issue number 11, issue number 12, issue number 13. Now these are the Doctor Who Weekly issues. I'm actually not missing any issues between number 1 and 236. So this is an unbroken run from 1979 to, like 1990 or something like that. A little after 90, I think. But I just got to run through these kind of quickly. As you can see, these are all bagged and boarded. And like I said in one of my videos from like 5 years ago, which had really horrible picture quality, even worse than what you're seeing here, I showed these arriving in the mail, and me looking at them and so forth. So at this time, the comic strip in the magazine was the main selling point. It was issue number 34. 35. Tom Baker was still the Doctor at this point. Issue number 36. Number 37. And we're going to get some more out here. All right, we got another stack here. So issue number 38. 39. 40. 41. 42. 43. 44. So now it's Doctor Who Monthly. 45, 46, 47, no longer a weekly. And as you can see, the focus now more is on the history of the show and so forth. Special Farewell to Tom Baker issue, number 51. Special John Pertwee issue. Legopolis, special Patrick Troughton issue. Introducing the Fifth Doctor, Peter Davison, issue number 55. 56, special William Hartnell issue. 57, 58, 59, 60, 61. The famous misspelling, Peter Davidson. It's supposed to be Peter Davison. 63, 64, 65, 66, 67, 68, 69, seen from Black Orchid, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, issue number 75, 76, 77, some really nice covers on here. And again, these were when Peter Davison was the Doctor. 79 and 80. And we'll get some more here. All right, we have some more. Issue number 81. 82. You see some writing at the top there that was from the original owner. I think they had them newsstand provider, write their name on it to hold the issue for them. 85, 86, 87, 88, 89, 90, Caves of Androzani, Colin Baker's now the new doctor, Tom Baker interview, 93, 94, 95, 96, 97, 98, 99, issue number 100, 101, 102, issue number 103, 104, 105, 106, 107, 108, 109, this is like 1986 now, 112, 113, 114, 115, yeah, like I said, an unbroken run. I'm only missing about 35 issues to have all number 100, number 1 to 558. 559 is one of the current issues. I have that in the mail coming to me. And 560 is the most recent issue that I know of. Now, this issue here, August 1987, number 27, at some point, I'm going to have to get an upgrade for it. It's really in rough condition. But it's sentimental value because this was the very first issue of Doctor Who magazine I ever read in 1989 when a friend sent it to me from England. 128. But like I said, it's looking kind of rough now, so I'm going to have to get an upgrade at some point. And it shouldn't be too hard. Sylvester McCoy is now the Doctor. And these issues from 1988, 1989. So 138, 139, 140, 141, 142, 143, 144, 145, 146, 147, 148. Now it wasn't too hard to get all these issues. You know, I did get some lucky bargains, though. You know, as I said in some of my old videos from like 5 years ago, where I posted about getting some from Mile High Comics and also a bunch of issues pretty cheap from a local comic shop. And 155, December 1989, so we're going to do the 1990s next. Okay, so here we're at January 1990, issue number 156, 157, 158. Now this was the second issue of Doctor Who magazine I ever got from April 1990. And I think, though, that's actually an upgrade from before. My other one was pretty rough. 160, that was another one I had early on. 163, again, I had that back in the day. 64, 65, 66 I need an upgrade on. 67 came with a record, a little flexi disc, which I have somewhere. 168, and those three I need upgrades on. They're pretty old and rough. 69, 170, 171, 172, 173, 174. I think this one had a Warren Ellis story in it. 175, July 1991. This one has a letter by me in it. The only time, as far as I know, my name has ever appeared in Doctor Who magazine. 176, and that's 1991. That's, what, 30 years ago. 78, 179, 180, 181, 182, 183, 184, 185, 186, 187. Still an unbroken run. Not missing a single issue of the main series, which is really nice. Unfortunately, I've not read all these, though. And, you know, it's like, it's even just getting the new issues, trying to keep up with the new issues. 198 is a difficulty. 199, let me start with 200 after this. All right, and this is issue number 200. 201, now we're in the wilderness years, as they call it, when the show was off the air. 1993, issue 205, 206, 207, 208. Although in the magazine is a little bigger size now, it's a little taller than it used to be before. And this is actually probably my favorite period of the show. This one's kind of rough condition. Great cover, but I need to get an upgrade at some point of that one. This one has a Doctor Who magazine index in it, which is, as it does this one, which is pretty helpful in finding out where stuff has appeared. There's also a website now where you can look up. They have indexed like most of the issues. Now this is shortly here. We start to get to where I have some holes. So 227, 228, 229, 230, 231, 232. You know, you would think that this would be a less interesting period of the magazine, but it's not. It's actually probably more interesting than usual because they really focus on history now since they don't have a new show to cover. So this is 236. This is 241. So I'm missing 237, 238, 239, and 240. So 241, 242, 243. I'm missing 244. But then I have all the rest of them until we get to 263, which I'm also missing. So that's 252, 253, 254, 255, 256, 257, 258. I think I bought this one when it came out, 1997, because of the Tom Baker interview. 261, 262, and then I'm missing 263, like I said. But then we go to 264, and I'm going to pause this and adjust these. Okay, so we got 265, 266, 267, 268, 269, 270, 271, 272, 273, 274, 275, 276, 277, 278, Curse of Fatal Death there, 279. This one is interesting because it's from 1999, but it has comments from Russell T. Davies and Stephen Moffat and so on, you know, talking about what the series might be like if it comes back, which of course it did. 284, 285, 286, 287, and we'll stop there and I get some more. Okay, so we're now on box number 3. And this is issue number 288, 289, and I'm missing 290. That's 291, 292, 293, 294, 295, 296, 297, 298, 299, and I'm missing number 300. So at this point, I've only missed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 issues out of the first 300, including 300. 301, 302, 303, 304, 305, 306, 307, 308, 309, and I'm missing number 310, 311, 312, 313, I'm missing 314, I have 315, 316, 317, 318, and 319. I'll get some more here. Okay, and I'm probably going to have to zip through some of these a little faster than before if I want to get through all these. So 320, 321, 322, 323, 324. I'm missing 325. Then we got 326, 327, 328, 329, 330, 331, 332, 333, 334, 335, 336. I'm missing 337, 338, 339, 340. I believe I bought that when it came out in 2004. 341, 342. I'm missing 343 and 344. As you can see, now we're getting into the Christopher Eccleston period here as the new series coming up. I remember I bought that when it came out too. And also this one, 2004, again, that was the issue that had the replica of issue number one in it. Okay, so I'm missing number 352, which is when the magazine changed its format. So this is the second issue of the new format. This is issue number 353. As you can see, we're now in the new stuff. I'm also missing 354 and 355. There's 356, 357, 358. I'm missing 359, 360, 361, 362. And we'll pause it there and I'll get some more. Okay, so we're at 363, 364, 365, I'm missing 366, 367, 368, I'm missing 369 and 370. If 371, I'm missing 372. And so we got 373, 374, 375, 376, and let's see here, I'm missing 377. We got 378, 379, 380, 381, 382, and I'm missing 383, I believe. Yes, the 384, 385. The numbers become kind of hard to read at this point. They get really tiny. And so I'm missing 383, but the next issue I'm missing is 395, so we got a ways to go here. And I'm probably just going to have to run through most of these to get them all in. I bought this at the time when it came out. Pretty awesome. Bad Wolf. Issue number 400. And now I'm just missing, for the 400s, I'm only missing 416, 420, 434, 437 and 447. That's all I'm missing from the 400s here. All right, so we're at 408, 409, 410. Let's see, I'm missing 416, which is coming up here. That's 414. So I'm missing 416. We got 417. I'm also missing 420, which is coming up. So that would be right in there. So 421, 422, 423. And then the next one I'm missing is 434. So we'll just zip through these real quick. And add some more here. This is the Nicholas Courtney issue 436, I think it is. So I'm missing 434, 437, and I'll be missing 447 as well. Some of these were issued with two covers. So in most cases, I just have the one cover. I don't have both covers. This is issue number 448, it looks like, so I'm missing 447. And so I now have every issue from 447, or 448 rather, I have every issue of 448 to the present, with the exception of 529 and 550, 551, 552. I'm missing those, which came out last year. And then I have 558, 559 in the mail to me. which I bought recently. And I don't have 5.56 yet, or 5.60 rather. You know, let me pause this. So I'm just about to run out of room here. So 4.62, 4.63, 4.64, the Peter Capaldi era begins. 4.65, 4.66, 4.67, and the 50th anniversary. Now I'm, and that's 4.70, 4.71. I'm going to do the rest of the books in part two in the future, because it looks like I'm going to run out of time here. So thanks for watching. We'll see you in part two, which I'll upload soon.